50 million Americans live with chronic pain, and many take opioids to deal with it.
But as Channel 2 anchor Christine Noel shows us, a new weapon in the fight against pain is some reaching for a virtual reality headset instead of a pill bottle.
How's that feel?
Feels good.
Mia Rabeck is doing amazingly well, just 4 months out of spine surgery.
I had what is called a meningioma, which is a benign tumor on my spinal cord.
She underwent a 5-hour surgery to remove the tumor, but Mia was determined not to rely on opioids for pain.
Pain medication was certainly a concern for me because I've seen the effects on family members and loved ones.
It became the quick fix, right? So we'll give someone a pill, and you know, then they'll be able to do more.
Physical therapist Jeff Hathaway says we were taught the body tells the brain how to perceive pain, yeah, when the opposite is true.
The brain decides whether the pain, the signal it's getting, is important and whether you should feel pain or not.
He says the key is giving patients the tools to desensitize their central nervous system and lower their sensitivity to pain.
Take a few slow, deep breaths in and out.
He's using virtual reality technology combined with physical therapy to help patients manage pain without pills.
Please rate your usual level of pain on average during the last week.
Patients were asked to rate their pain level and concentrate on mindful meditation. Mia did the VR sessions pre and post surgery. She only took 3 of the oxycodones she was prescribed.
This is a game changer. We can see a complete elimination or at least a reduction.
You can manage your pain without pain medication.
Mia is feeling stronger every day and says if she can do it, anyone can.
The developers of the VR therapy hope to make it part of a physical therapy regimen in centers across the country. Right now, insurance covers the VR sessions as part of a physical therapy program. If used without insurance, the cost is $90 a session. I'm Christine Noel, KPRC Channel 2 News.